are going to start a new chapter, alcohols, phenols and ethers. That is, in this chapter we have to study about these three compounds, alcohols, phenols and ethers. First, let us start with alcohols. Alcohols are considered as hydroxy derivatives of hydrocarbon. Okay, alcohols are considered as hydroxy derivatives of hydrocarbon. That means from hydrocarbon, that is aliphatic hydrocarbon, if you remove one or more hydrogen atom and substitute it by hydroxyl group, it results in the group of compounds termed as alcohols. So they are considered as hydroxy derivatives of hydrocarbon. Is it clear? So we can say that they possesses the general formula CnH2n+1OH. These alcohols are having a lot of applications in everyday life. Okay, now let us study about the classification of alcohols. On the basis of hybridization, we can classify alcohols into different types. First one, let us see on the basis of sp3 hybridization. Students, you must be remembering how we classify haloalkanes on the basis of hybridization. The same way we can classify alcohols also on the basis of sp3 hybridization. For example, if you consider a compound CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. In this case, you can see that the hydroxyl group is directly attached to sp3 hybridized carbon. This type of compounds are commonly termed as alcohols, or we can call it as alkanols. On the basis of IUPAC system, this group of compounds in which OH is directly attached to sp3 hybridized carbon is termed as alkanols or alcohols. Is it clear, children? Suppose if you consider another compound, CH3 single bond CH, double bond CH, single bond CH2OH. Now in this case, you can see that OH is again attached to sp3 hybridized carbon, which is adjacent to a double bonded carbon in an aliphatic compound. The compound is aliphatic in nature, but OH is attached to sp3 hybridized, which is adjacent to a sp2 hybridized carbon. It is termed as allyl alcohol. Okay, children, it is termed as allyl alcohol. On the other hand, if OH is attached to an sp3 hybridized carbon which is attached to a benzene ring, then it is termed as benzyl alcohol. Is it clear? If OH is directly attached to an sp3 hybridized carbon of an aliphatic chain, then it is termed as alcohols or alkanols. If it is attached to sp3 hybridized carbon which is adjacent to a double bonded carbon, then it is called allyl alcohol. And if OH is attached to a sp3 hybridized carbon which is adjacent to a benzene ring, then it is termed as benzyl alcohol. That is about the classification on the basis of sp3 hybridization. Now let us consider on the basis of sp2 hybridization. Just like haloalkane, I mean, we can classify alcohols also into two on the basis of sp2 hybridization. For example, if you consider CH2 double bond CHOH. In this case, you can see that OH is directly attached to a double bonded carbon of a straight chain. It is attached to a double bonded carbon or sp2 hybridized carbon. Then it is termed as vinyl alcohol. It is called vinyl alcohol. And if OH is directly attached to a benzene ring, sp2 hybridized carbon of a benzene ring, then it is termed as phenol. Is it clear? That is about the classification of alcohol on the basis of hybridization. Now let us consider the second type of classification, that is on the basis of number of hydroxyl group present. Okay, on the basis of number of hydroxyl group present, we can classify alcohols into three. First one you consider, I'll give you an example and you can define me. Third one you consider it as. You consider the first type of compound, then you can see the presence of only one hydroxyl group. This type of compounds, that is alcohol which contain only one hydroxyl group, is termed as monohydric alcohol. Monohydric alcohol, that is alcohol which contain only one hydroxyl group, is termed as monohydric alcohol. So can you tell me why this term is, I mean, what is the name for this type of alcohols which contain two hydroxyl group? Yes, it is termed as dihydric alcohol. For monohydrate, we can consider simple example. Ethanol is an example for monohydric alcohol. And dihydrate, you can consider ethane-1,2-diol. Yeah, ethylene glycol is an example for dihydric alcohol. And if alcohol contains 3-hydroxyl group, then it is termed as trihydric alcohol. Propane-1,2,3-triol is an example for trihydric alcohol, or its common name is glycerol. Is it clear, children? That is about the classification of alcohols. Now let us just pass through nomenclature. As when I explained you about the classification, there only I told you that in order to explain the nomenclature of alcohols, we have to just consider, that is alkane, since they are hydroxy derivatives of alkane, you have to remove this E and add the term oil to this. So the compound becomes alkanol. This is the official name of alcohols. It becomes alkanol. For example, if you consider CH3, CH2, CHOH, CH2, CHCl, CHCH3, CH3. Now let's see this compound. Here again you can see that the rule remains the same. You have to select the longest carbon chain and give number to the chain in such a way that the functional group should get the least number. So you can see that if you are starting from right to left, the functional group will be getting the number 5. But on the other hand, if you start from left to right, you will get the number 3. So let us start from here. Then you have to arrange it alphabetically, so we can consider the compound as 5-chloro-6-methyl-heptane-3-ol. Is it clear, children? Since OH is one of the most important functional group, you have to, otherwise also, since it is the functional group, give numbering in such a way that the functional group bearing carbon should get the least number. Is it clear? Let us consider one more example. Okay. So can you tell me what is the name of the chain or compound? Okay, you have to collect this as the longest carbon chain. Okay, so it will be 4-methyl-hexane-2-ol. Is it clear? This is how you have to give the names to this organic compounds. Is it clear? Now let us see the isomers present in case of alcohols. If you just consider this alcohols, they will be showing both structural isomerism as well as stereoisomerism. Is it clear, children? Alcohols will show both the type of isomerism. It will be showing structural isomerism as well as stereoisomerism. In structural isomerism, let us see what are the isomerisms exhibited by alcohols. For example, let me explain it with the help of example. If you consider CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2OH, and you consider another example, CH3, CHCH3, CH2OH. Children, if you observe these compounds, both of them possess the same molecular formula, C4H9OH. But the first compound is butane-1-ol and the second one is 2-methylpropane-1-ol. Yes, that means they are showing difference in carbon chain. This type of isomerism, in which the compound shows difference in carbon skeleton or carbon chain, is termed as chain isomerism. So this is the first isomerism exhibited by alcohols. Second one, you consider the same example, CH3, CHOH, CH2, CH3, and let us consider CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2OH. Okay, these compounds are 2-butanol and 1-butane-1-ol and butane-2-ol. Is it clear? Butane-2-ol and butane-1-ol. Yes, the position of functional group is different, so it is termed as position isomerism. Okay, another example let us consider. So the second type of isomerism is position isomerism. Third one let us consider, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2OH. Yes, this is butane-1-ol, and you consider CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3. That is ethoxy-ethane. So here you can see that both this compound shows difference in the functional group. So this is an example for functional isomerism. Alcohols and ethers are functional isomers of each other. Is it clear, children? So alcohol shows 3 types of structural isomerism, that is chain isomerism, position isomerism, and functional isomerism. Okay. And if you consider under stereoisomerism, this compound will be showing optical isomerism. In last chapter, we have studied what is optical isomerism. Yes, the compound which can rotate plane polarized light due to the presence of chiral carbon. For example, if you consider CH3, CHOH, CH2, CH3, that is butane 2-ol. Here you can see that, see the presence of chiral carbon, where all the four valences are satisfied by different atoms or group of atoms. Due to the presence of this particular chiral center, we can see that this compound will be showing optical isomerism. Is it clear, children? So alcohol shows chain isomerism, position isomerism, functional isomerism, as well as optical isomerism. Okay, rest we will do it next period. Thank you, children.